And welcome to this Saturday edition of Quick Pitch, presented by Blue Emu. What was a jam-packed schedule? We're in Flushing. Jacob deGrom was rocking and rolling against the Fish until some jazz ruined the Maestro's performance. The pennant-winning
Brandon Nimmo said the Mets ace is used to this, but is it the Mets offense or the starters stepping it up against deGrom? Obviously, the two-time Cy Young Award winner has the lowest ERA in the majors over the last four seasons. But the guys who started against deGrom, now if we cobbled them all together and made them into a single pitcher, would have the ninth best ERA in the sport. Now the guy that's 10th on the list made his season debut in Hollywood against the World Series champ. In the postseason, the Yankees have been held in check by their division rivals, losing 15 of their last 19. The Bombers' six straight losses against the Rays ties the longest losing streak against an opponent since the advent of the wild card. As a casualty to the loss, Domingo Germán, who in his two starts has allowed seven runs in as many innings, was sent down to the team's alternate site. Now before we head out to the Charm City for the Orioles and the Red Sox, prior to the game, Boston announced they placed their hottest hitter in J.D. Martinez on the COVID-19 injured list due to cold symptoms. Red Sox manager Alex Cora does expect him to be back on Sunday. Now, if Martinez tests negative twice, he can be activated from the list. Now, let's get you to Baltimore. Well, it seems like the A's have finally recovered from the sting of their ALDS loss against the Astros. After dropping the first five against Houston this season, they've scored more runs in their last two games against their division rivals than in the previous five games combined. Still to come, the Rangers got a hit. Slate shrank to 14 after the postponement of the Royals-White Sox game on Saturday due to the rain. The contest will be made up as part of a split doubleheader on May 14th in Chicago, with Game 1 starting at 1:05 Central Time and Game 2 beginning at 6:05 Central. Now, a reminder, all doubleheaders during the 2021 season, like last season, will be seven innings each game. Now, let's see how their crosstown rivals fared in the Steel City. Longtime Giant has struggled against lefties recently, especially from the power department. So the homer off of Ben Bowden comes as a surprise. Among left-handed batters, Brandon Crawford had the third lowest slugging percentage against southpaws. It was the two-time All-Star's first homer off a lefty since July of 2019, when it came off of flamethrower Josh Hader 99 at-bats ago. Now out in Minnesota, a left-handed hitter who impressed in the spring got the scoring going. Earlier in the show, Jacob deGrom had his ace stuff working in Flushing and another tough luck loss. The 32-year-old right-hander now has 20 winless outings, but at least six innings while allowing one run or fewer, dating back to the start of the 2018 season. The next closest on the list has nine. Among those with nine is deGrom's former teammate Steven Matz, now with Toronto, who plays in Dunedin. Confusing. I know. Highlights. Alert, we have all the feels as we congratulate Rockies host and play-by-play announcer Jenny Kavnar and her husband Steve on the arrival of their second child, Emery K. Spurgeon. Now we're happy to report that both Jenny and Emery are doing great, and if she's anything like her mother, this little one has a bright future ahead of her of breaking barriers in the sports world. Well, that does it for this edition of Quick Pitch. For our great crew here at MLB Network, I'm Lauren Gardner. See you later.